Good morning, everyone. Myself, Dr. Shefali Gupta. I am working as professor in Chitkara University, Curing Department. I am here to represent a topic on adaptive filter, that is a way of image restoration. What is image restoration? Image restoration is the operation of estimating the original image from the corrupted or noisy image by applying the inverse process. What it means? It means if we have an image that is corrupted due to some atmospheric disturbance or environmental factors or some noise is added, then we have to get the original image from that corrupted image. That process is called the image restoration. How it works? See this thing. This is the input image fxy, and this pass through the degradation function, that is h. This degradation may be due to some atmospheric disturbance or maybe due to image capturing, due to remote sensing. It can be due to anyone. And then some noise is added to this image. So this, after adding the noise, we get the image gxy, which is a corrupted image after degradation plus adding the noise. So now through this, from this degradation image, degraded image, we have to restore the original image, that is f cap xy, means it's approximation of the original image. So this process of getting the approximated image from the degraded image using the restoration filter is called the image restoration. Example, I have taken the example of Lina image. This is the original image Lina, which is degraded through the motion blurring. Right here it is deliberately motion blurred is applied, but this blurring may be due to some reason, like atmospheric, I have told, atmospheric, environmental, any other reason, it can be corrupted or degraded. So our main objective is to get the original image from this degraded image. Now, how the image, degraded image, is represented in a mathematical form? That it can be represented in two domains, spatial domain and the frequency domain. In spatial domain, it is represented by gxy, that is equal to hxy convolution fxy plus nxy, where hxy is the degradation function, fxy is the original image, and nxy is the noise function. So this degradation function is convolved with the original image, and that convolved output noise image is added to it, noise function is added to it, so we get the corrupted image or the degraded image. In the frequency domain, it is represented by this equation, where capital letters represent the frequency domain and small letters represent the time domain, right? So in frequency domain, it will be GUV is equal to HUV multiplied by FUV. Now here in time domain, it is convolution, but in frequency domain, it is simply multiplication. So convolution is converted to the multiplication in the frequency domain, and then plus NUV, that is a noise in the frequency domain. So this is the representation of degraded image in the spatial domain and frequency domain. Now how to restore a degraded image? To restore the degraded image, we have to apply the inverse process. How to do it? See this thing. This is the equation of the degraded image, as I have told earlier. Gxy is equal to hfxy. This is the convolution of this plus nxy. So what we have done? This is the approximation of fxy. It will be equal to the, for this nxy is subtracted from gxy, that is gxy minus nxy, and then apply the inverse process, that is a h inverse. So we will get the restored image. Now here we will do image restoration in the spatial domain. Here we have considered the corrupted noise, corrupted image, in which only noise is added. No, we have not considered a degradation function. We have considered a only noise is added. So in that case, we will use a spatial domain. How it is represented? In that case, gxy will be equal to fxy plus nxy. Now you can see no hxy is there because no degradation is there, only noise is added. When we represent in the time frequency domain, it will be represented in this way. Capital G will be equal to capital F plus capital N. It is xy in time domain and uv in the frequency domain. So for that time domain, we are using the adaptive filters, means in which only noise is added, we will use the adaptive filter. So where it is used? In many practical scenarios, it is observed that we are required to filter a signal whose exact frequency response is not known. So means if we don't know the exact frequency response of the noise, in that case we will have to use the adaptive filters. That is, we are using in the spatial domain, we are not using the frequency domain. So our solution for such problem is an adaptive filter. So what is its beauty? Its beauty is that it can automatically design itself and can detect the system variation in time. What it means? That it will detect where the noise is, means in the local region where the noise is. It will make small windows of the complete image, and in that small window, based upon the statistical parameters, it will analyze where the noise is. And if the noise is present, in that case it will filter that noise. If no noise is there, in that case it will not filter, means it will pass as it is the image. So it can detect system variation in the time domain. How it works? Mathematically, adaptive filter can be represented in this equation. Approximation of fxy is equal to gxy minus sigma n square upon sigma l square into gxy minus ml. What it's saying? Where gxy is the noise image, sigma n is the global variance, sigma l square is the local variance, and ml is the local mean of the image. How they are calculated, we will do it by example. So how it behaves, behavior of adaptive filter. Here, if this global variance is zero, if this factor is zero, in that case this complete factor will be zero, and if this is zero, then approximated fxy will be equal to gxy in that particular region, right? So when this is zero, sigma n square, that is a global variance is zero, it means it will be considered as a zero noise. Zero noise means in that region no noise is there. So if no noise is there, then output image should be equal to the input image, right? The next point, B point, if local variance is high, if this local variance is high as compared to this global variance, what will happen? Firstly, when this case will be there, when the local variance is high, it means some edges portion are there, means that particular local window, that particular local region is associated with edges, some edges are there, and that is not a noise. And if it is not a noise, then it should be preserved, right? So mathematically, you see, when this sigma l square is higher than the sigma n square, in that case also this factor will become very small. So this factor, complete factor, that becomes negligible. So approximated fxy will be equal to gxy, right? In both the cases, approximated image will be equal to the actual image, original image, means gxy, because in the first case noise is zero, and in the second case there are edges. Now come to the third case. If the two variances are equal, when sigma n is equal to sigma l, now what will happen? If they both are equal, then what will happen? So it will be 1, this factor will be 1, and then it will be gxy minus gxy plus ml. So gxy will be cut from gxy, and only ml is left. What is ml? ml is a local mean. So what it means? When sigma n is equal to sigma l, it means there is some noise, and if some noise is there, then that pixel should be removed with the local mean. So that's why that gxy will be replaced by local mean. So if the two variances are equal, then return the arithmetic mean value. In this case, local area has the same property as the overall image, so the local noise is simply reduced by averaging, right? So we have done three cases. If global variance is zero, second thing, if local variance is high as compared to global variance, and third, if two variances are equal. Now mathematically, how they will happen, that we will do it by some example. Let B is an image matrix which is corrupted with the Gaussian noise. Now this is the image which is corrupted with the Gaussian noise, and we have to restore this image. How to do it? Firstly, what we will do, we will define a window of size m by n. We will take a small window size, let m by n is 3 by 3, right? So we will take a window of 3 by 3. Now second step, pad the matrix B with zeros on all the sides. You can see we have padded this matrix with the zeros on all the sides, right? Next, the next step, we will take the 3 by 3 for each pixel. Let coming to this pixel, first pixel of the image matrix B, take 3 by 3 window, neighboring window, and compute its local mean. How will you compute its local mean? You just add all these pixels, that is 9 pixels, you add these 9 pixels and divide it by 9. You will get the 0.4373. So this value will get 0.4373 for this pixel. In the same way, come for the second pixel, that is this pixel. Right? For second pixel, I will take this one window. Third window. For this, I will get the output 0.6505. So, we will get the local mean of each and every pixel by taking the neighborhood of 3 by 3 areas. So, this is called the ML or the local mean. Means we have got this factor ML of the image. Local mean of the image. The next is to get the local variance. Now, we have next step is to get this local variance. Now, what is value of local variance? What is the formula for that? Local variance is given by mean of B square minus mean of B, then complete square. How to calculate it? Firstly, we will find the mean of B, that is ML, that we have done in the last slide. So this is the ML or mean of B. Now mean of B ka square means we have to square this complete ML. How to do it? We will square each term, means 0.4373 ka square, that is a 0.1913, 0.6505 square is 0.4232. In the same way, each and every pixel is squared and we will get the mean of B complete square, right? So this is the mean of B complete square. The next step is to get the this mean of B square. So for this, firstly we have to find the B square. How to find this B square? We have the B. This is the B. Now, in the last slide, we were having the B. So, we will square each pixel of the B. So, when we square the each pixel of B, then this is the B square. Right? So, here each pixel of the B is squared and we will get this matrix. So, this is the B square matrix. Now, next step is to find the mean of B square. How to find the mean of B square? Start from the first pixel. So take again 3 by 3 window and then add these all 9 pixels and divide by 9. So the same way we are getting the local mean. So this is the local mean of B square. So we will get the 0.4307. Next, come to the next pixel. Again take the 3 by 3 window of this pixel and then just add these 9 pixels, divide by 9, we will get 0.6355. The same way we will get the local mean of B square for every pixel. Next, now we have got this mean of B square and mean of B complete square. Now we have to just subtract these two matrices. This is mean of B square and this is mean of B complete square. So just subtract these two matrices and we will get this one. This is called the local variance. Right? So this is the local variance matrix. Now we have got the two matrix, that is a local mean matrix for the image matrix B and the local variance matrix, the image matrix B, right? So we have got the two matrices. Now we have to find, the next step is to find the global variance. We have found the local variance. The next step is to find the global variance. How to find the global variance? Global variance can be found by taking mean of all these values. Means how to do it? We will add all these terms. These are 16 terms. Just add these all 16 terms and then divide by 16. So that will be the global variance or overall noise variance. So its value comes out to be 0.1709, right? So this is the equation. Now one algo is there for this. What it do? It will, for each and every pixel, it will check that if global variance is greater than local variance, in that case it will put local variance is equal to the global variance. I am repeating it. If global variance is greater than local variance, in that case it will put local variance is equal to the global variance. See this thing, this is our global variance. Global variance values comes out to be 1 only, that is 0.1709, and local variance is for every pixel, right? Now for each pixel we will check, we will compare its value with the global variance, right? So check this value, that this 0.1709 is greater than 0.2394 or not. So this is not greater, so we will not do anything, so this will remain same. Next go for this 0.2124, again this is less than 0.1709, again nothing to do, remain same thing here, same thing here, and same thing here. Means all these five values, they all are greater than the global variance, so nothing to do here. Now but come to this pixel 0.0009, here local variance is less than the global variance, so what will happen, we will replace local variance with the global variance, so this will become equal to the 0.1709, right? In the same way, next pixel, this pixel and this pixel, these all four pixels, they all are less than the global variance, so these all are replaced with the global variance. Now ultimately we have got this matrix for the local variance, right? So now we will use this equation. How to do it? Now see this thing, we have sigma n square, means this is the global variance which is 0.1709, this is the local variance which is this one gxy, that is a b image we have got, and this is the ml, that is local mean, right? So just subtract ml from gxy and then put this sigma n square by sigma l square then this complete value will be subtracted from gxy and we get this matrix. This is a restored image. So this complete is a mathematical operation which we perform in adaptive filter. Generally students use MATLAB command directly to use the adaptive filter. They don't know what's happening at the back end of the adaptive filter. So this mathematical example is just to show that how it's working at the back end. So these are the results of the adaptive filter. This is the image which is corrupted with the additive Gaussian noise of zero mean and variance 1000, right? So this image is restored using arithmetic mean filter, which is the B figure, and then geometric mean filter C, and then adaptive noise filter. So by the figure visualizing it, it is very clear that adaptive filter is much much better than as compared to arithmetic mean filter and geometric mean filter.